Hello students, how are you? Hope you are fine and hope you like my previous video regarding networking, LAN, MAN, WAN. So in my today's video, I'll explain you about network devices. So in network devices, we learn about modem, hub, switch, repeater, router, gateway. So all these devices are having different role while we are creating a network. So plays a different role. So first we can learn about modem. So here you see the picture of the modem. So what modem is? The modem term basically comes from the modulator and demodulator. So what modem is? It is a hardware component that allows a computer or other devices to connect to the internet. So basically with the help of the modem we can connect to the internet. So in other devices, router and switch we can use. So about them to we will discuss in upcoming session, not now. About switch we will discuss now in this video. So what modulator is? So it converts or modulates an analog signal from a telephone or a cable wire to digital data that a computer can recognize. So the signal which comes from the telephone wire or a cable wire, so that signal is a analog signal, and which signal computer can understand, that is called a digital signal, or it is in the form of zeros or one. So the process of converting from analog to digital is called modulation. Similarly, it converts digital data from a computer or other devices into analog signal that can be sent over the standard telephone lines. So its reverse is called demodulator. So in which the digital signal is once again converted into the analog signal so that can be transmitted to the other devices. So this is the working of the modem. So here you see modulation means analog to digital conversion, and demodulation means digital to analog, or digital form 0 or 1, analog this is in the form of the sine wave. Now the next topic, next we will learn about, so our topic is hub. Next is hub. So what hub is? So there you see the picture of hub or switch. So both looks same. Hub is a device that allow us to connect multiple computer or devices together in the network. We want to make a local area network, we can use hub so that we can connect multiple computers there with the help of this hub. A hub has ports in which the cable from the individual computer NICs are inserted. These are the ports. So a cable comes from the individual computer and inserted into these ports. This way each computer's NIC is connected to hub. First, NIC. NIC is a network interface card, which is nowadays already comes with all the pieces inbuilt. There is no need to separately insert a NIC, it is inbuilt in almost in all the computers nowadays. So whenever a computer has to send some information to some other computer, the information is sent by the NIC to the hub. So in the case of a hub, suppose we are having a 5 computers or 4 computers connected to the hub, and a computer A wants to transmit some data to D. So what A do? A send that data to the hub first, then the hub transmit that data to all the pieces, all the nodes which are connected to that hub. So then the hub retransmit this information to the other computers attached to it. The computers for which the information is intended receive this information and accept it. In the case of the hub, rest of the pieces reject that information but the intended computer accept that information. So that is the working of the hub. Now the next topic, first briefing simply. A hub is an electronic device that connects several nodes to form a network and redirect the received information to all the connected nodes in the broadcast mode, we can say. Now switch is an intelligent hub. It is also a hub, but it is intelligent. How it is intelligent? Let us see. It looks exactly like hub. It has the same functions as that of hub to connect multiple computer or devices in the network. But the difference between the two is the way they retransmit the information. In the case of the switch, information is transmitted only to the intended node, not to the all the nodes. Likewise case in the hub, it broadcasts it, but the hub transmits the information only to the intended node. So that's why a switch is called an intelligent hub. So the a switch sends the information selectively only to those computer for which it is intended. This makes a switch more efficient than a hub. Now briefing, a switch is an intelligent device that connects several nodes to form a network. That is clear that it forms a network and redirect the information only to the intended nodes. This is makes the difference between a switch and a hub. Now see the difference between switch and hub with the help of a diagram. So there we see that hub is there, node A, node B, node C, node D. So A is a sender and D is a receiver. So here we see that A sends a data to the hub. What hub do? Hub rebroadcast or transmitted that data to B, C, D, all the nodes. So B and D reject it, but the D accepts it because it is related to the D node. So this is called broadcasting. Node term, node anything which we can connect to the internet, network, computer, printer, scanner, etc. So in the case of the switch, we see node A transmitted data to D in the case, not to the rest C or D. So that's why a switch is called an intelligent hub. So topic of today is over. Thanks for watching my video. Hope you like it and stay at your home. Be safe. Tata, bye bye.